Hey everybody, it's Camera Tim, and I'm going to show you how to replace a color with another color in DaVinci Resolve and stuff. Now ordinarily, when you see a color change or replace color of some sort, you're using a qualifier with hue versus hue, or a color warper, or something similar like that. But what we're going to do here is replace a color with a specific color value. And when you click on that button, you'll see that that gets replaced too. I didn't do that one in Resolve though. It was already there from YouTube. So we're gonna jump right into Resolve here, and we have a screenshot from the W3 Schools website that I'm going to show this example on because it's a pretty decent example. The first example I'm gonna show is on the color page. I'm also gonna show a couple examples of how to do this in Fusion and why there's different ways to do it. I'm gonna go ahead and remove the clips, remove the gallery, and make sure my effects are turned on. So the effect that we're going to use on this is called the color compressor. So we're going to drag that onto our node here, and we're going to bring our compress hue, saturation, and luminance all the way up and turn the tool off for the time being. And we're going to go to our qualifier tab, and under the qualifier tab, we're actually just going to go and I'm going to replace this green button with a different color button here. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the green to make the selection. And then I can press Shift H to see what selection I made. And it grabbed all this other green too. So if I wanted to isolate just this area, I can just go to my power windows here and I can either do a rectangular mask, circular, or just even draw a mask. Doesn't really matter which one as long as you get the selection that you want. And I can go ahead and press Shift H again. Now I know I have my selection here. I'm gonna go ahead and turn this icon off so I don't see it anymore because I don't need it. And as soon as I turn the color compressor on, you'll see exactly what we're doing here. Now I'm going to go ahead and select my target color. And when I click on pick screen color, now I can choose a specific color value that I want to change this button to. You'll notice some fringing on the color. We're going to address that in a second. So we're going to go ahead and just select this color right here, hit OK. And now if we needed to refine this fringing here, what we can do is actually go back to the qualifier tab and maybe just reduce some of these points or increase them depending on how we want to approach it, just so we get the right selection here. And sometimes we can even go to the second page and just add a tiny bit of denoising, but sometimes it'll just immediately put too much denoising on it depending on the size of the image. So we can just add maybe just a little bit of blur here just to hide it a touch. But when we zoom out, it's not really too noticeable, and we can click this on and off if we can tell that we've changed the color. So that's how you do this on the color page, and that's a very basic example. You can try this on a number of different types of colors. But I'm gonna go ahead and reset this for now. We're actually going to go back and go into the Fusion page. And I'm gonna show two different examples here. The first one is gonna be very similar to how the color page works. And I'm gonna go ahead and press Shift Space, and I'm actually going to use a clean plate instead of a qualifier because we don't really have a qualifier in the Fusion page. And then I'm also going to press Shift Space once again and bring in our color compressor. I'm gonna go ahead and drag the output of media in into the color compressor separately. We don't want it to be on the outside of the clean plate. So when you do add it, just make sure clean plate is not selected or it'll add it to the line in front of it. So I'm gonna go ahead and drag the output of color compressor into media out. Now the clean plate's not connected to anything, but that's because we're actually using the clean plate to select what we're going to adjust here. So I'm gonna go ahead and bring the clean plate into the first viewer by pressing one. I'm gonna zoom in on I'm going to press Control and zoom in, and we're going to select the green button once again, and we're going to replace it with this dark purplish bluish. I don't know what it is. I didn't look at my notes beforehand, but we're just going to click on the clean plate, look at the inspector, and we're going to click this eyedropper next to background color, and we're just going to drag it over onto the green. And then in order to just clear everything else around it up that we don't want to select, we're just going to go ahead and add a rectangle. We can also do a polygon, ellipse, doesn't matter which one you use as long as it gets the proper selection. I'm just going to use a rectangle for now. And the key thing is we don't want to actually put this into the blue input. We want to put it into the white input for garbage matte. And the easy way to do that without messing it up is just by right clicking and dragging from rectangle onto clean plate. And then we can select garbage matte. And then we can just go ahead and turn our rectangle off so that we can make our selection much easier. So we can just move this mask down here and bring the corner down so that it only selects a spot. And then we can turn it back on and then select invert. And now we have only the area that we want to adjust. And so then we just drag our clean plate onto our color compressor here under the mask part. And that's essentially telling the color compressor, only do this effect where we're telling you to, which is in this area. So when we go back to our color compressor here and bring our compress hue, saturation, and luminance up, we're only doing it on this spot. And we can go ahead and do that same pick screen here after we select our target color. So we can go ahead and pick screen color, and we can see that we can select it. Looks like it is kind of bluish, but it also has a bit of a purple. I'm getting sidetracked. And if we wanted to modify our selection at all to kind of get rid of this tiny green fringing here, we can always go back to the clean plate. We just bring our threshold down just a tiny bit, just to clean it up a little. But that's how you would effectively do the same thing. You could also add a blur if you wanted to. So we can go to the blur effect and we can just add a tiny fraction of blur just to hide it a touch. And if we bring the blur up into the first viewer, you are just seeing that little extra nudge of softness. But again, this is only acting as a mask, telling the color compressor, whatever you see here, that's not an alpha channel. That's what we're doing the effect on. Now, the way that I have found is the most clean is actually by using the delta key. Now, this is the third method we're going to use. I'm actually going to use a different image here just to showcase it on a different image, but I'm going to go ahead into Fusion. I'm going to go ahead and press shift space and select the delta key. And I'm going to add a clean plate just in case. And I'm going to shift select it to take it off of the line, and I'm going to drag media in into the clean plate and pull that into the first viewer just in case we need it later. So I'm going to go to the delta key right now, and let's say I want to replace these red dots here with a different color. We're going to do this similar tactic. We're going to click and drag this eyedropper onto the background color that we want to replace, and then we go to the matte tab and go to replace color. And then we're going to click and drag this eyedropper on the color that we want to replace it with. Let's just say it's this bright blue here, and change replace mode to hard color so that it replaces the color precisely. And then if we just bring a road dilate to 0.1 or something like that, which basically means it's either expanding or retracting the key that it's doing. And if it retracts, it uses the replace color to replace what it's retracting. But then we have our replacement here. And if we zoom in, we're actually getting a pretty good replacement here. And if for some reason we didn't get as good of a replacement as we needed and we have some fringing on the edges, we can still do a similar thing with our clean plate. We'll just go to background color, click and drag the eyedropper onto that color that we're trying to replace and select that same red again. And then we can just drag our clean plate onto our delta key, because the delta key will know that it's a clean plate coming into it. So it automatically puts it into the pink input, which is the clean plate input. So then I can potentially grow these edges or reduce the threshold or something, but basically it's just telling us where that key is supposed to be applied. Clean plates and delta keys are usually used with green screens, and a clean plate is used to essentially fake a full green screen by itself. And that allows the delta key to have more green screen information in order to cut things out. But we can use a similar tactic here to kind of fix edges on certain colors that we're replacing. Now, sometimes this clean plate step isn't necessary on the delta key version, and sometimes it does give us a worse result, like this case here. But there are times when if there is edge fringing with no clean plate attached, then a clean plate would help clean up those edges. But this is a pretty solid replacement here. And I just want to show another example really fast. If you had an image that has an alpha channel, and I just put a rectangle mask to simulate this, but let's just say it does have an alpha channel. When you connect a delta key to it initially, it'll have a black background because it's expecting to key out some stuff, because by default, the delta keyer will ignore alpha channels. But the easy way to fix that is just go to the mask tab in the delta keyer, and then where it says solid source alpha, just click subtract, and then you have your alpha channel back again. So those are some ways you can do some direct color replacement in DaVinci Resolve, and each of them has their own use case, and some work better than others for certain cases. Just depends on what your needs are, but feel free to try each one of them. If you run into any issues or you have additional ways to do direct color replacement, please let me know in the comments. I do like engagement. Or even if the comment is just about your favorite color, that's engagement. And if you want to see how to replace a 2D logo with a 3D logo, watch this video, because it shows exactly how to do that directly inside of Resolve, and all in the free version still. No studio plugins or anything. So watch that, and I'm gonna sign out. I need to replace this outro.